India is today secular, if India is today liberal, if India is today very open society, it is because its ethos is Hindu. Hindutva is not against anybody. Rahul Gandhi is a better Hindu than Yogi Adityanath. The government is tacitly or clandestinely supporting the jihadi and other terror violent forces. Every Indian should be happy that you are actually reinventing the soul of this country, the soul of the society. Terror incidents have come down in the state. Look at the data. The activists are aligned with Sangh Parivar have been the targets for many, many years now.
Ram Madhavji, namaste and thank you very much for being with us and talking to the viewers of Tattumayi TV. Let me start our conversation with your latest book, that is Hindu Paradigm. The book definitely is going to be discussed a lot, and obviously there will be criticism also. The main criticism, why Hindu paradigm? Why not an Indian paradigm? You have been for years now trying to explain what Hindutva is from various platforms, equating it, it's the same as nationalism or Indianness or something like that. But obviously the other side will ask this question, why Hindutva? Hindutva is not an inclusive but an exclusive ideology. What is your take on that?
No, in this book talks about a non-Western paradigm, which is very essentially Indian. Hindu, Hindutva, Hinduism are all the same thing. There is a political effort to create a distinction between Hindutva and Hinduism, but there is no such distinction. Hinduism's Indian translation is Hindutva. This book is about India's civilizational cultural ideas. For many decades now, the whole world got exposed only to the ideas from Europe, but we from this part of the world, especially from India, have also given excellent ideas for human development, human progress, human unity, global unity, all those things. This book talks about those ideas. That is what Hindutva. Hindutva is not exclusive. Hindutva is not against anybody. It is inclusive. It is about oneness. It is about love. It's not about peace. It's not about exclusion. This book actually explains that very fundamental ideational aspect of Hindutva or Hinduness or Hinduism, you call it.
Okay. I hope our readers will go through this book and understand themselves. But definitely some people remain unconvinced. Rahul Gandhi, for instance, only last week he said, I am a Hindu but not a Hindutva Vadi. So that distinction is clearly being made. Being a Hindu, yes, I am proud of being a Hindu. That was not there some 20 years back. Nobody used to say proudly that I am a Hindu, especially Congress and or other leaders. Now they are saying that I am a Hindu, but they will make that distinction between Hindu and Hindutva. So what is your take on that?
No, they are halfway through accepting the reality. Right. As you rightly said, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, they used to say that Hindu means communal. We are secular leaders, we have nothing to do with Hindu, etc. Those very same leaders who used to accuse us of being communal because we talked about Hindu, Hindutva and all that, are today saying we are Hindu, you are Hindutva, we are better Hindus. No, now Uttar Pradesh elections are taking place. Okay. What they are telling the people of Uttar Pradesh is very interesting. They are saying Rahul Gandhi is a better Hindu than Yogi Adityanath. No, that at one level sounds very ridiculous, but at another level, it's also a testimony to the fact that even those people who originally opposed Hindu, anything to do with Hindu, Hindutva, Hinduism, have actually travelled halfway. Very soon they will fully realize today for political reasons they are trying to create a distinction, but yet they are accepting they are Hindu.
You mean that there is a shift, which is happening.
Shift has happened in the country. People today have made Hindu, Hindutva as this country's mainstream. Since Hindutva, Hinduness has become the mainstream of this country, you will find a Rahul Gandhi claiming to be a Hindu and a better Hindu. You will find a Mamata Banerjee claiming that she worships Durga Mata and she is a Brahmin and etc. etc. People you find wearing Janeu and roaming around, and Mr. Kejriwal traveling to Ayodhya, and you know, taking all senior citizens of Delhi to Ayodhya for a darshan. So it is because there is a fundamental change, transformation at the societal level in India.
There is a there is another group of people, especially the communists, the leftist liberals, so-called leftist liberals. They say India, the idea is totally different from what Sangha Parivar says. India is a liberal, India is a secular, India is an open society, and Sangha Parivar is doing just the opposite.
India is a secular, liberal, open society precisely because it is Hindu based society. Hindu not in any religious sense, but its culture, its civilization, its value system is what is called Hindu. If India is today secular, if India is today liberal, if India is today very open society, it is because its ethos is Hindu. May I ask, these worthies, what happened to Pakistan?
Exactly.
Which got separated from this very country. Why is it not a secular country today? Because the ethos here has always been for those values. That ethos is what we call as Hindu. By the way, those who oppose, you said the left and others, they have now become leftovers. They are remaining in some part. They are remaining strong because of certain political equations in states like Kerala. Otherwise, there is an ideology. It is an ideology completely rejected, not just in India, all over the world.
So you are happy with the shift that is taking place in Indian politics?
Every Indian should be happy that you are actually reinventing the soul of this country, the soul of the society. That is very much Hindu, Hindutva, Hinduness, Hinduism.
Ramathoji, I know you are very busy. Let me move on to one or two other topics. One is Kashmir. What has happened in Kashmir was phenomenal. That change no one expected, and you are one of the persons who played a pivotal role in that. Looking back now, after this much time, what do you feel? Has the objective been achieved in Kashmir? That is the integration of Kashmir. That was the
real issue. Of course, the political integration by removing the constitutional hurdles in the form of Article 370 has been achieved, and it has delivered very good results to the state in the last 2.5 years. Now, people of the state are no longer with terrorists and separatists. The soft separatist politics has ended in Kashmir. Today, the politics, mainstream politics in Kashmir is no longer about Pakistan or separatism. It's about other political rights like statehood, etc. To that extent, political change has happened, which is good. Lot of economic development is happening, even to the extent that today pundits are returning, because 3,000 jobs have been offered to them. People from other parts like Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, other parts are going in search of livelihoods to Kashmir.
True.
It is the terrorists who are scared of this migration,
but
who are targeting them.
That target
that should be understood. Terror incidents have come down in the state. Look at the data. In fact, the number of terrorists killed in the last 2 years is all-time high. 359 terrorists have been neutralized, and terror incidents have come down drastically. They are targeting migrants because they realize that if this trend continues, very soon they will not have any takers in the valley. So that is the good change that has happened in Kashmir. Economic development, greater integration with the country, reduced terrorism, and no space, no support for soft separatism in the valley. That is the new picture that is evolving in Kashmir, which is good for Kashmir, good for India.
Good for India. Now, coming to Kerala directly from Kashmir, because many people now fear that Kerala is going to be the next Kashmir. The terrorist jihadi network that we witness here in Kerala, even today as we speak today, it's a Black Sunday. An innocent person has been murdered. There was another person, Sanjit, who was murdered few weeks back. So Hindu workers are being targeted, BJP workers are being targeted, Sangha workers are being targeted. And the jihadi network, terror network in Kerala has full support of the administration. But is the central government and the BJP national leadership or the center, giving that much attention to Kerala.
We all must put pressure on the state government here to act, because maintaining peace, securing the lives of the citizens, law and order maintenance is primarily the responsibility of the state government. In this state, the Hindu activists or the activists aligned with Sangh Parivar have been the targets for many, many years now. And despite our best efforts, that series of incidents has not stopped. As you rightly said, today's was a very unfortunate, very tragic incident. But before that also, a couple of months ago, one incident, 6 months ago, another incident. Continuously, our people have been on the target, on the hit list of violent terrorist elements in the state. It appears as though there is no government here. Government is unable to control. Either it is helpless or it is tacitly supporting those forces.
It is tacitly supporting for pure political gains and returns.
If that is the case, government should act. People should realize that the government is tacitly or clandestinely supporting the jihadi and other terror violent forces.
Sir, Popular Front is one organization that has proved to be a terror-related organization for many incidents. It's not only working in, it has its headquarters and base in Kerala, but it's working all over India. You know, even Uttar Pradesh, Hathras, when that happened, PFI people were apprehended. So, isn't it time to ban this organization and suppress their activities, finish off their network?
No, in the state, whatever measures have to be taken must be the primary responsibility of the state government. As far as national level steps to be taken, those are concerned, Government of India will take appropriate steps.
One more question regarding India's neighborhood. India's neighborhood is not what it was few months ago. China is flexing its muscles. Pakistan is now on an advantage situation after Afghanistan, what happened in Afghanistan. Do we need to be more careful and
vigilant? We are living in a competitive neighborhood where China is also proactively trying to court and cultivate a number of countries in our neighborhood. For us, it's not just a competition for influence. For us, it's a civilizational relationship. The countries in our neighborhood are our civilizational cousins. This relationship is not just political. It has not started after 1947. This relationship dates back to our civilizational history. So the government of the day, Prime Minister Modi's government, is making all the necessary efforts to strengthen this relationship with our neighbors. I'm sure neighbors also have the same reciprocal attitude towards India.
Okay. Ramathavji, thank you so much for being with us. I know you have a very busy schedule today, and I am very happy to have you in Trivandrum after a gap of 2 years. Because of Corona, you could not come here. Thank you so much for
being here. Thank you, my pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.